go.
I've been thinking about that a lot, because when you are a freelancer, you cannot really rely on an employer to develop you. And once you take that jump, it's a completely different mindset. And you cannot really, obviously you take different projects to learn from them, but you cannot position that as your selling proposition. You're being hired to get something done. So I guess that there are two ways to look at learning as a contractor, as a freelancer. So one of them is the usual thing. It's about reading, it's about attending events, listening to seminars, maybe webinars, podcasts, especially lately. Definitely meeting up with people. I do that a lot. I think one of the best pieces of advice that I've ever gotten was to not be afraid to cold approach people on LinkedIn. So if there is somebody who you are interested in meeting, if you just send them a connection request or a message, obviously introducing yourself, not just, you know, somebody wants to connect with you on LinkedIn. If you send that request, the worst thing that can happen is they're not gonna reply to you and they're gonna forget that you exist. And the best thing that can happen is that they're gonna actually reply to you and you're gonna get coffee and you're gonna learn from them. So I think that's one part of learning that I practice. And definitely, I think I probably meet at least one brand new person every month just using this approach. And another one, I guess, it's picking the kinds of projects that stretch you and creating learning opportunities for yourself on those projects. For example, it's very easy to feel very comfortable. You develop a certain kind of, say, e-learning. So you're very well known, for example, you have very many leads to develop that kind of thing over and over again. And it's very easy to fall into that trap. Mm-hmm. But picking projects that are completely different from each other. So for example, wow. Most recently, after I finished a long stint creating high visibility, big budget corporate projects, I started working with startups with virtual reality, with alternative MBA, which wow. is not even digital. But it made me think, it made me reassess my assumptions about what learning is. And then this is something that I'm going to carry forward onto my other projects, and definitely made me reassess everything from processes, from how business works, what value I create. So there's a lot of doubt, a lot of self-doubt, but there's also a lot of confidence to be gained from it, definitely. And it's also about being conscious on those projects. So it's not just about creating a diverse portfolio, which is obviously good, but it's also being conscious about how fortunate you are. Being able to work on different things. So yeah. As a freelancer, it's up to you to choose what you work on or to actively pursue projects that may not come naturally your way. And it's about very consciously experimenting with your thinking. Maybe, you know, I accomplished something using this process that way in this organization. Now this is different. Just observing how it all works out and what you can learn from that experience. So really putting in all of the reflection, just practicing what you preach as a learning designer, and just experimenting on yourself and with yourself.